Hey, Raindrops. Before we begin part two of my exclusive interview with Nene Leakes, I just want to say, on behalf of Nene and I, thank you so much for watching our part one interview, for making me and Nene and the podcast trend worldwide on the internet. Yes. And for your outpour of love and support. You know, me and Nene are super thankful for you all for watching and tweeting and telling a friend. I love you all. Thank you so much. And thank you all who purchased merch off of my website, carloskingshop.com. You can get this shirt, Raindrops Represent. Yes, hoodies, mugs. Where's my mug, child? Here we go. Yes. All on carloskingshop.com. Pick up a merch and watch this video. Here it is, part two of my exclusive interview with Nene Leakes, where she gets into everything. Thank you again.
Why did you feel the need to sue Bravo, NBC, and Andy Cohen?
First of all, I can't say that much about it because we are still, in our lawsuit. But I had a love and respect for them that I honestly don't think they ever had for me, honestly. And to this day, I still respect them for what they do. They do it great. You cannot take that away from them. They're great at what they do.
Absolutely.
Unfortunately, I wasn't experienced enough to know that in a lot of these corporate places, they don't love you. I mean, you're here to work, and then they can throw you out the door anytime they feel like it. I love them, and I had personal relationships with them because when I started Bravo, they were big, but they weren't big like they are now. So my contact people were, I talked directly to, the president of the network, and directly to Andy, and directly to all the executive. I just talked to them directly, emailed them directly, called their phones directly. Today, they have grown so big that people aren't talking to them directly. You're talking to someone else to get to them and that kind of thing. All I ever wanted on this show was to be treated fairly. And a lot of girls and the people that work on the show and behind the scene know that there was things that just were not fair at all. And it pains me and hurts me deeply how I fought for some of the girls that are on the show and how they did not fight for me to stay on the show and how much I fought for them to stay on the show. That's very painful. And
Who exactly?
the cast, period.
Okay.
Like all of these girls know that there was unfair treatment because we all have been in group text messages where all of these girls have texted and said that they were feeling unfair treatment. They didn't get fair treatment. There's no secret. I have the text messages. They have the text messages. We've all been in group text messages for a very long time since we've been on the show, right? So I know the complaints. There's been times when we have complained and we all sat with the executives to talk about, things that we felt that were not fair. And I just felt like I wasn't getting fair treatment. And I feel like I should have been treated differently. And I should have been giving better, fair treatment. That's it. And I want you to know that I have always, from day one, been very open to sitting down and having a conversation to figure out how to work anything out, how to move forward, how to just anything that we could do to just move forward. I've always been very open to that. I can't say that the other side has been that way, but I have always been open. So I see a lot of people commenting and saying things like, why y'all can't work it out or why can't y'all do this? I've always been open to working it out. I've always, people say, well, maybe Nene didn't want to do it. That's not true. I've always been open to working it out. I've always been open to having a conversation. They have never wanted to have a conversation or they've never wanted to move forward in any kind of way.
Is what led to it was that you were negotiating to come back season 13, if I'm not mistaken, maybe that. And allegedly, you were offered a limited role role to come back, a maximum of 6 episodes.
That's right.
Out of what we now know to be 20-something.
Mm-hmm.
And was that the start of you realizing that, okay, I'm not getting the treatment that I deserve as an OG, as the person who gives so much to the show, that you have these other girls who don't give y'all nothing, and they get 14-episode guarantee, minimally. And here I am getting 6. Mm-hmm. Was that the moment you realized something had to be done?
No. I realized long time ago.
Okay.
And I think that I'm not sure if they realized that I realized that I wasn't getting fair treatment. I knew it long time ago. I had been watching it for so freaking long. And as time went on, my episodes got less and less and less and less. It was like a phase out. You know, oh, you started out with 20 or 18, and you went to 16, and you went to 15, and you went to 12, then you went to 10, then you went to 8, then you went to 6. And I'm thinking, you guys are offering me 6 episodes? Like, no, this has nothing to do with I'm NeNe Leakes, and I started from the beginning. It was just like, why am I being offered 6 episodes? Like, explain that to me. And the only explanation that I could get was that you're unhappy. So in my mind, you gonna tell me I'm unhappy? How can you tell me that I'm unhappy? I'm not unhappy. What do you mean? I just get 6 episodes because you think that I'm unhappy? Why am I unhappy? I'm unhappy that I got 6 episodes. I mean, shouldn't I get more than 6 episodes? Like, why is it a phase out? When there's other girls who are not the same complexion as me and started as an original housewife, why are they being offered 18 episodes and I am being offered 6 episodes? What did I do? Because I don't know anything that I've done ever on this show that no other housewife in this franchise have not done. I've not done anything that no one else has done. There's been physical altercations on all of these shows, and I've not been involved in any physical altercation, right? There are so many times when people say things to me like, you pulled Kim's wig. I said, you got it very mixed up. I never pulled Kim's wig. That was Sheree that pulled Kim's wig, okay? Be clear about who pulled it. I was standing there, right? And then people say, you got into a fight with Kim. Where is the fight? Did you see it? Where is it? Was it on camera? Where is the fight? You didn't see me in a fight anywhere, anytime, ever on this show, right? So you have girls on other franchises pulling each other's hair, busting glasses. You know, they say, well, you left the reunion. Well, what reunion have you seen that a housewife didn't get up and walk off the show or walk off a reunion? So I would like to know what it is that I did that someone else did not do. These girls have done way worse than I could ever have done. And then you go to, oh, well, you pushed the cameraman. Well, so he was in the way. Okay. Now what else is going on? So Teresa pushed Andy down at the reunion when he tried to stand up. So what else are you talking about? So there's nothing that I've ever done that no other housewife haven't done, if not worse. So I didn't understood why I was being given less and less and less, but I wanted to understand from their side. Mm-hmm. Why? What did I do? You can't tell me it's because, you know, you make too much money, you know, when you got these other girls who are making more money. You know, what is it that I was doing? I saw what it was, and I've been watching it for a very long time. And all I asked for was fair treatment. That's it.
Bethany Frankel is a very outspoken housewife.
Yes, I spoke to her recently as well.
Oh, what was that about?
Go ahead. Oh. What's your question?
Bethany Frankel has been very outspoken about housewives in a very negative light.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
I think she speaks out and says things, but I also think she teeters a little bit around. Like, I think she knows what to say and what not to say.
Well, yeah. What's interesting to me is because I do listen to her podcast. She talks about how much money the girls make. She talks about how, you know, the housewives show now is a bunch of women fighting. I won't go back. They have this book. They asked me to be interviewed for, and I'm like, I'm not gonna be a part of a book that talks about women this way. Like, she speaks about it in a very negative light, but she also gets invited to watch What Happens Live. Mm-hmm. Do you think that there's a different treatment between you and Bethany, at the end of the day, you both are outspoken women.
Yeah, there's a very big difference. First of all, you just said that she gets to get invited to watch what happens live. I am the only housewife that has been on Watch What Happens Live. I'm sorry. I've been on Watch What Happens Live more than any housewife. Certainly when he first launched the show. They used me and used me and used me to sit there over and over and over and over and over and over again to help launch Watch What Happens Live and make it a success, and the success that it is today, because I personally do not think that Watch What Happens Live would be successful without the Real Housewives franchise, period. I don't think that Andy would have any of his success without the Real Housewives franchises, period, because that is where he's known from, is the Real Housewives franchise. And I also think that Bethany can speak and say things that I can't speak out and say. I could say some of the same things that Bethany is saying right now, and I would get criticized, or I would not be invited here or invited there, and I certainly wouldn't be able to hang out with anybody in the Hamptons. I think she can say whatever she wants to say, and it's okay. I just am not in that position. I can't say whatever. And she will still work. And I think if we speak and say some of the same things that she said, we can no longer work. Opportunities are being taken away. You're not invited here. We don't like her. We don't want to work anything out with her. I don't get that same opportunity.
You made some allegations about Kim Zolciak.
First of all, where Kim Zolciak is concerned, I think all of the girls on the show all have felt some kind of way, including production, about Kim Zolciak. Now, that is not a secret. And I have the text messages to prove it. We have sat in meetings to discuss Kim Zolciak being able to do things that we're not able to do, i.e. take a trip together. None of us want to take those trips together because we know those trips are intense. And we know that you're going to be confronted and there's going to be some sort of confrontation. But for whatever reason, Kim was never had to take any of those trips. We all had children. We had to leave our children behind. She never had to do that. She could skip the trips and stay home. And we would have to be the ones out on the, and she still got her check. And we still had to be on that show, on that trip, having confrontations, making sure this show was a success, and Kim would show up when she was ready to show up. And that is just the truth of the matter.
If Andy Cohen is watching right now, what is it that you would like to say to him?
Hi, I heard you had two babies now. Congratulations, you have a girl. That's amazing. I always knew you wanted to be a parent, Buttercup. I don't have any hard feelings. You know, at one point, you know, I'm a Sagittarius. So at some point, you know, I may be mad with you, but then I get over it. Mm-hmm. I'm not the kind of girl that carries a grudge or hold the grudge forever. I'm also not an ass kisser. Again, I'm a Sagittarius, so I don't generally kiss ass, and I will not kiss ass. I would just say that I hate that we're in this place. I really wish it was a way for us to find our way back to each other, because, you know, life is short and you just don't want to carry ill feelings for the rest of your life. You don't have to work together. You don't have to do anything, but it would be nice to either just work through the issues. There's been so many people with greater issues in friendships and they work through them. As I said to you earlier, Cynthia and I will never be best friends again, but we have talked and we've worked through whatever issues we have. So when we see each other, we can laugh, we can talk, and we can sit at a table together. We can work together. I think it says a lot about a person when they can't just say, let's just move on. We'll work through that moment and let's just move on, because I honestly don't have any ill feelings. What happened has happened.
Is the end result of this, I know you can't speak much on it and we'll move on, but is the end result of this lawsuit, would you like to go back on Atlanta Housewives?
I can't say that I personally would just like to go back on Atlanta Housewives. However, the fans have all asked for me. And the fans are the reason for the ratings. They're the reason for the show being as popular as it is. And if I had to go back, it would be 100% for the fans.
Okay, not the check.
The check is not a bad check, although I think my check should be bigger. The check is not a bad check.
Do you watch the show now?
I do not watch the show. However, I have watched a lot of the clips that come down social media. I don't even know how to turn my TV on. I think everybody that knows me, including Andy Cohen, knows this about me. I don't watch TV.
What do you think about the clips you've seen online?
I thought the clips online, well, they weren't, you know, that entertaining. I've had the opportunity to meet a lot of the girls that are on the show currently. And just meeting them in person, they weren't entertaining, or they were not like... I just don't see any stars on the show.
So we have Kenya, Candy, Sheree, Sonya, Drew, and Marlo. Out of those six women, do you see any stars in them?
I do not.
Okay. How do you feel about Marlo getting a peach?
You know, from what I've heard and from what I've seen, Marlo is the one that's bringing the most entertainment on the show. Now, we really have a problem. So if Marlo is the biggest entertainer on the show, they have got to do something.
Why is that?
No, not that she's not entertaining. Mm-hmm. It's just shocking that this has been a person that was a friend to the show for many years. And now she is bringing the most entertainment. That says a lot about those girls who've been holding those peaches for years. They need to take away their peaches and let them become the friend then. Because if she's being the most entertaining person on the show, that's crazy. Some of those girls have been on the show. They are paying some of the other people probably way more than they're paying Marlo, and Marlo is the most entertaining. Then they need to give Marlo some of these other people's check, and some of them need to, you know, take a back seat.
Does Marlo deserve to have a peach?
You know, I think so now, yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
A lot of people have said that Marlo is the reason why you don't get a friend of a peach. They feel like
that's
Marlo-
why you don't do what?
People have said that Marlo is the reason why you don't give a friend of a peach.
A friend of a peach, okay.
They feel like Marlo was best served as a friend of to the show. Pop in, pop out, and goodbye. A lot of people can't stomach Marlo being full-time. They don't think she has the gravitas to hold the candle of what a peach holder brings to the show. And they feel like she was better served as a friend of. If you were still on the show, would you have wanted Marlo to be a peach holder posing alongside you in the main titles?
I can understand what people are saying and what they mean, but I have a relationship with Marlo. So therefore, I'm happy to have a friend that I know to hold a peach, you know? Mm-hmm. But I understand what they mean. It's sort of like, now... why y'all gave her a peach? I get what they're saying. Mm-hmm. But I'm happy seeing Marlo in the role, though. I get it.
Do you think Candy's overrated and overpaid?
I do.
Mm-hmm. Tell me why.
I just don't think that, you know, me and Candy, just so for the record, so that everybody can know, I just always want to speak very freely and very honest. Candy and I have severed any issues that we had, which I don't think that I never ever understood why she has so much animosity towards me and some of these other girls who are ripping her apart like she's back friends with Portia now. And I love Portia, mm-hmm. but I would not be friends with Portia if I was Candy. According to what Portia and Phaedra did to her, then she should probably never be friends with her again. But she's found a way to bridge the gap, and now they're there talking. So I get it. But it felt like to me like Candy held the biggest grudge against me, and all we had was petty little arguments and stuff. I think that Candy is not exciting. I just don't think she's an exciting. I don't think the camera loves her. I just don't think the camera loves. I think the camera loves her family, but I don't think they love her. And so I don't think the viewers or anybody would ever see Candy as much as they want to make Candy like the star. And she's like, she's been there for 100 years and she is her. I don't think not one person tunes in and believes that. Mm-hmm. I believe everybody tuned in and be like, okay, there's Candy. okay, now what's going on? Where's Kenya? Okay, where's Dexter? I don't think that anybody tunes in and be like, oh my God, she's just bringing it and she's so everything. I think people look at it and they be like, okay, next. I don't think anybody is like that with it. I just don't. And I have to go a step further and say, I believe that production and the network wanted it to be that way. I think that they wanted girls on these shows who did not have the it factor. I said years ago that most of these girls have the I, but they do not have the T.
Atlanta Housewives at one point in time was the number one show on the network consecutively for more than 5 years, arguably. Mm-hmm. It no longer is. The number one show on Bravo is Below Deck. The number one Housewives show
Beverly
is
Hills, isn't it?
The number one show of Housewives is The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. Mm-hmm. Atlanta Housewives, I think, has fallen to the number three slot.
And I think they wanted it that way.
You do? Mm-hmm. Why?
I just do. I just think that they did not want these girls to be the number one show. I just do. That's just a personal thing. I just feel like they just did not want these girls to continue to be number one. That's just my opinion.
Why has Atlanta Housewives slid from the number one spot? And people are saying that the show has now become unwatchable.
You're asking NeNe Leakes why?
Do you like what? Okay, listen. Do you want my opinion?
Sure.
Okay. And I'll get red for this, and that's fine.
I don't know why you would get red for having an opinion.
Oh, God forbid I have an opinion, honey. It goes on Shade Room and hey, Shade Room. Hey, Neighborhood Talk. but it's fine. I'm going to be very honest with you.
Okay.
And this is me speaking as a producer on the show. Mm-hmm. I started out day one as an associate producer, bottom mm-hmm. level. So I've seen things from a bird's eye view, like this is how it works. Mm-hmm. That show needs an anchor. Mm-hmm. That show needs somebody, which I'm saying to you is always you. That mm-hmm. show needs somebody that can rally the troops. Mm-hmm. My all-time favorite trip of Atlanta Housewives history will always be Savannah. Mm-hmm. I love Savannah. You have fun. There was a shade, mm-hmm. and it was really sisterhood. Yeah. And I'm not saying this because you're in my face. I said this mm-hmm. Behind your back. You were able to orchestrate the conversations, and they mm-hmm. I saw them look to you like, what are we doing? When you said, okay, let's pick room, let's go upstairs, they all looked at you like, NeNe is the anchor, and that's not shade, mm-hmm. and that's why the problem to me now is there's no anchor.
You are by far the shadiest showrunner I've ever sat with, by far. And one of the great things about you, as I said earlier, is that you know all the girls. You knew what made us tick. You knew I'm going to call NeNe in, and this is going to piss her off today. Or you knew to call NeNe in, and NeNe could call us on. You knew those things because you had a personal relationship with each and every one of us. And each and every one of us were able to call you when we needed something. And that's the great thing about you. So when the other showrunners come in, they don't know us. You know what I mean? They don't know our personalities.
Or try to get to know y'all.
Yeah, try to get to know us. You knew our children. You knew our husbands. Mm-hmm. And all those things made for a great show, with you being able to know all of our relationships. And I will tell you what me and my glam talked about before coming out here. Like Destiny's Child. It could never be Destiny's Child without Beyoncé. And I feel like I don't want to give myself that, but the truth is, I started the show. Again, I shot the pilot. I did season one. I am an original housewife. I knew what the show needed. I gave the show everything it needed. And I think it's very difficult to grab that person and take them off of the show and really think that you're going to be able to put somebody else in that position. It just could never work. Mm-hmm. It just could never work. And I don't think it will ever work. Now, what I do feel like they might possibly could do, I'm not sure if it's going to work, is to tell everybody it's been real.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Agreed.
And start a whole new cast. Yes.
Yes, I agree with that.
Other than that, to keep trying and bringing these people back in and out, in and out, in and out, it's just not going to work. We already know what they did. You gonna bring them back? Yes, she was fun. Why'd you take her off in the first place? Okay, you bring this person. Why did you take her off? Why is she back? You know, it's just like, what are you guys doing? And the friends of the show is who I'm confused by. I'm very confused by the friends. I am looking at the show like, who are the friends? And why are they here? That's where I keep looking at. Like, why did the friend get here? Why is she the friend?
Mm-hmm.
And why is she on the show? I'm confused.
Is it sad to see the house you built crash and burn?
Oh, it is. Oh, it is. Oh, it is. I've said it so many times. This is a shame. And it's a shame that they don't get what it needs. That's the real shame, is they don't really understand what the show really needs. It's really simple to us. I mean, we're looking at the show like, this is really simple. Where is the fabulousness of the show? Where is the girl? I feel like you do too. I'm not if everybody's there just to get a check, but it's a lot of girls who are not working, who are not giving they all. Like Kenya, for instance. We know that Kenya can give.
Oh, baby.
We know that she can read.
Yes.
We know that she can come in and do a whole scene, but we're not seeing that. And I think that is because she's not interested, because there's not interesting talent there for her to be interested in. Do you get what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So if she had somebody there.
She's bored.
Right, she's bored. If she had somebody there to read, then she can get read, and then she would be, you know what I mean?
Yes.
Like, girl, you're about to get read, because you ain't finna take me there, because I'm finna come for you. And so same thing with Candy. You need somebody to grab her up and take her there, because otherwise she's just chilling. You know, so she's just like, okay, I'm just getting this check. But you bring some of these girls in here who are going to really read you, girl, and not really care about you being here for 10 years, then you're going to do your job, because we're about to gather you now. And so I think they just missed it. They just missed it. And they need other girls to come on the show. Now, I do hear that Marlo is reading Candy a lot. I will have to go mm-hmm. do my research, but I hear that she is reading Candy for the gods.
Not the gods, Lord.
Yeah, so call the gods, honey. Say, Candy's getting red, honey. Yeah, Candy, come through Candy now. Now I know Candy can scream back, honey, so come on. So she's doing her job. So it seems like Marlo is doing her job.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And
yes.
Who else is working on the show now?
Sheree's there.
And what is she doing?
She started off dating Martell.
Oh, right, and she's no longer with him. I got to cross my leg, I'm sorry. And she's no longer with him.
And I felt like there were moments of her becoming an anchor.
Oh, they were trying to get her to become an anchor. I could see that. Maybe best because she's an original. But I don't think she has it in her to rally the girls and give them that voice and be that person. I just don't see it.
Let's talk about your friendship, your celebrity friendships. You and Wendy Williams had a great friendship at one point in time.
Yes.
She is now going through something very troubling.
Yes.
And it doesn't look good for her, unfortunately, and we're all praying for Wendy. But going back to y'all great friendship, at one point in time it ended. I'm gonna be very honest with you. When Wendy's talk show was on, bitch,
I know what you're gonna say.
It was appointment television. I love Wendy and I still love Wendy. But you're my girl. Mm-hmm. And people know we ride for each other.
Yes.
I did not like when she referred to you as the girl over there.
Mm-hmm.
I just didn't like it. Because I felt like, and this is no shade to Wendy, I felt like at some point in everyone's life, we're that girl or boy over there. Mm-hmm. We all are that at one point. Wendy was that doing radio. Yeah. And then through the grace of God and his blessing, you have a daytime syndicated talk show, which is huge.
Mm-hmm.
You're not somebody that was, you're the biggest reality star in the world.
Mm-hmm.
So to refer to you as the girl over there, like she was better than you, I didn't like that. Mm-hmm. And you two were still friends. When she would say that about you, would you call her and be like, nah, bitch, what's really going on?
I would be very confused. There's many times when I've called Wendy. But also you have to know that I'm one of her friends that were kind of on the inside. So I saw a lot of things. And I would take it with a grain of salt where other people would take it personal, right? So Wendy saying that, I knew then that, you know, something's going on with mm-hmm. Wendy at this moment, because that's... You know, she wouldn't say that in the other case. So my friendship with Wendy, I would have to say this, was off and on a lot. I would have to say that I really liked her a lot. And when she was fun, she was really fun. I enjoyed going to New York, being with Wendy, going out and having drinks with her, going to her beautiful place that she has. We would go out to dinner and drinks. I saw her switch on me, like, right in the same day, you know, change and I don't know what happened, but change and be something else or do something else. But honestly, I really liked her. And every time, it would be like we're having a great time. And then suddenly, I would turn on the TV, and she would be saying something about me, and I'd be like, we were just having a damn good ass time. Like, how do we get here now? Like, why is she saying that about me? I would try to think to myself that it was because she was doing TV, and she was just making a great show. But I would always even say to her, that Wendy, you have to have at least like two friends that you're going to be friends with, and you're not going to be going in on them, like two. Like, you can talk about everybody else, but these two friends right here, like, I'm going to say them. But it would never be me. I honestly felt like Wendy was in a place where she didn't care about any of her friends anymore. And she would just say whatever she had to say. I hated that because I really liked her as a person. No matter what was going on her show, no matter what was going on in her personal life, I just liked her as a person.
When was the last time you spoke to her?
It's been a while. I would have to say the last call, she made it to me. And she was trying to, I feel like, trying to resolve whatever, like, hey, how are you? I'm sorry. You know, like, trying to apologize.
Was she off the talk show at that point?
I want to say, I think so.
Okay.
And not off the talk show. They had not said her show was gone.
Okay.
It was a moment when people were like hosting
Yeah,
or something.
Substituting her seat. Yeah.
And we just, at that moment, I didn't even want to hear it. So.
Is it true that you had a talk show with Tom Arnold, a deal for you and Tom Arnold to have a talk show, kind of like, you know, Kelly and Ryan? That was going to be produced by the same production company who produced the Wendy Williams show, and that when you two got into it and you made a statement that you're mad that I'm coming for you, that she gave the production company an ultimatum, and ultimately they decided to not pursue the talk show with you and Tom Arnold.
I had a deal with Detmar Mercury, and which is the same company that produces the Wendy Williams show. And I'm not sure if they had locked in my co-host at the time, but we did have talks with Tom Arnold and others. I don't know if he had a deal with them as of yet, but I had a deal in the works with them. And she and I got into our thing. I think I had a Birkin bag, and Kim Kardashian had one, and we had put graffiti on it. And she said that, you know, like, she can't afford to do that, but Kim them could afford to do it. And I was like, listen, Wendell, you know, and when I said that, you know, we kind of went back and forth, and both of us was at this women empowerment thing, and just went super left. All I know is we went back and forth, and they pulled my deal.
How did you find out they pulled the deal?
Through my attorney. The deal wasn't going any further. And I was like, why? And it was, I said something in the press and everything, whatever they said, I said, because we can Google it. Whatever it is that I was supposedly said, I didn't say it. But at the end of the day, Detmar Mercury pulled my deal, and I no longer had a deal to do a talk show. And probably the last deal. Well, I've had a couple people to come to me about doing a talk show, but I've never been able to do a talk show since.
Why is that, you think?
I don't know. Like, I was put on the list of can't do a talk show.
Do you think you're blackballed?
I was, very much so. I have been able to work, you know, a little now, but for a long time, yes. Mm. And definitely in certain areas, like podcasting, no. Talk show, no. That's always been a no for me. Like, no matter, I've wanted to do a podcast or wanted to do a talk show, it's always been a no. It's always been a no. And I've had many people to come to me with offers, and then they just die.
So you would get presented offers for talk show and podcast, and you engage with them, and then all of a sudden it goes away.
And all of a sudden it goes away.
Like a phone call was made or something.
Yes. We could be in a full-on negotiation, and suddenly it just goes dead. That has happened many times.
Does that make you sad, though?
It makes me very sad because the one thing I always say is I'm a black girl with blonde hair. Now, I can't be you and you can't be me, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So what I bring to the table, you're not actually bringing to the table, mm-hmm. right? And I also think there's enough money out here for everybody and for all of us to eat. And who even says that my podcast or my talk show will even be successful? Like, give me the opportunity. Let me have the chance to be able to do it. So I was in many talks to do many things and they would just die. And that's not by chance. That's not by chance.
What is it that you would like to do now? Like, what is on Nene's vision board that if someone's listening who's able to grant you the opportunity of your dreams, what is it that you would want right now in this place in your life?
I love talk. So obviously talk is probably in the forefront. I love to talk and I love to act. So podcasting, talk shows, TV series, all those things. I love everything entertainment, though, honestly. Probably one's no greater than the other. I love any and everything entertainment.
Do you think you should be bigger than Kim Kardashian?
Absolutely. If not bigger, right there with her. I feel like they pushed Kim and they didn't push me. Kim came on after me. And they opened up every door and every opportunity for her, even putting us together at times and making her, you know, much more bigger than me. She had North, obviously. I was at North Baby Shower with her and Kanye, but they pushed Kim to the front and pushed me to the back. And I don't think that was by chance. I think that was the way they wanted it to be. We were together because I was Nene and I came out before her, and it just kind of looked good for us to be together. That's how I feel. Mm-hmm. Chris had a talk show. I co-host with Chris on the talk show. I just think that they made her more successful, and she was able to get opportunities and open walk through doors that they just did not want me to walk through. She did Shoe Dazzle, I did Shoe Dazzle, mm-hmm. around the same time. And they just pushed her stuff forward, and they were always giving opportunities. And one other thing is that whenever we had businesses, it felt like we couldn't really show them that much on our show, but on their show, all they do is talk about their businesses. And all they do is, you know, talk about launching their makeup lines or their clothing lines or their whatever they're doing. And I don't feel like we were able to do that as much. So I just wasn't given the opportunities that she was giving.
I want to play a game with you.
Because not a game. I don't play games.
You were famous for saying some people are stars and starless. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to say some names. And I want you to tell me if they're stars or starless. Gisele Bryant.
Starless.
Robin Dixon.
Starless.
Kenya Moore.
In between. Star his. I don't know. You know, I think, honestly, can I talk about Kenya a few minutes? I feel like there was a moment when Kenya could have been this big star, because she was to the black community, because she was Miss USA and she was this beautiful black Barbie that had won that pageant. And I feel like coming on Housewives changed how people saw her and viewed her. I think showing her mean side or whatever side that was, aggressive or in your face side, I think the people that enjoyed watching pageants enjoyed her as Miss USA. When they saw her in that role, they were kind of like shocked, like, oh my gosh, she's like a villain, because she was a villain. And I think it changed how people felt about her, because people really put her on a pedestal and looked at her one way. And then once she stepped onto Housewives, I think they saw her another way. So I do think there was a moment where Kenya was a star. And I think I would have to say that reality didn't help her star. That may be a better way to say it.
What about Portia?
You know, I think Portia has star potential. And I think with the right people around her, I think there is a potential.
Phaedra.
I don't see Phaedra as a star, not as a TV star or anything like that. I always view Phaedra, I'm sorry, as more corporate or entrepreneur-like. I don't see her like TV star. I see her like entrepreneur star.
Candy.
I don't see Candy as, I've never, and so I can't even pretend today, I've never seen Candy as a star. I have seen Candy as a supporting star, but not as the star, but as a supporting star.
Claudia Jordan.
Starless.
Who won between you and Claudia in Puerto Rico?
I'm always the winner, and so I obviously won. But I will give Claudia this, although she said the most nastiest things about me, and she's been holding on to a grudge for 100,000 years. I would have to give, I'm going to give her this. I've read many of girls, honey, and I've been on this show with many girls. I would have to say that she was probably my number one battle.
Bitch.
She was definitely right up there to battle with. Yeah, I don't think that there's not been one other girl that could probably battle the way she did, because I took her through it, and I feel like she took me through it. And so I feel like we gave each other a run, and not many girls can give me a run. So I will give her, I feel like she definitely stood up.
And I want people to know this too. You told me and Joy after mm-hmm. that scene between you and Claudia, because Demetria was being positioned mm-hmm. as a peach holder. Mm-hmm. And you told me and Joy, y'all picked the wrong bitch.
That's right.
And Claudia, I want people to know peach. That because you're not this yeah. hater. No. You mm-hmm. always did what was best for the show.
I did.
You said mm-hmm. that bitch Claudia, mm-hmm. she's good. That y'all need to give good. Her a peach.
Y'all done got rid of Portia. You need to give Claudia the motherfucking peach, because Claudia was really going toe-to-toe with me. And I will give her that every single time. Although she wants to feel like I ripped her toes apart and pulled her Hello Kitty out, honey. At the end of the day, girl, you stood up, honey. I will give you that much, girl. You stood up, honey. Because the reeds were coming. I was pulling them out from under my wing. I am not lying. And she, that's because she was giving me a run.
Oh, and everything. We were, me yeah. and the producer were in the back like this. Yo, what the yeah. fuck is
she
happening?
She was giving me a run, and I was like, girl, I'm going to have to win now. And so I was going hard. But she was hard, too. So, you know, she wasn't easy. She wasn't easy. She did her part. She earned her peach.
So not Kenya, not Sheree, not Kim, Claudia Jordan.
Claudia earned her peach. Kim can't read me, child. You know better. But, you know, they can all try. But I must say that Claudia definitely stood up. She stood up. She wasn't afraid.
When it's all said and done, Nene, mm-hmm. what would you like your legacy to be?
Oh, God. I don't know what I want my legacy to be. What I do know is that... I want people to know that my heart is bigger than this entire room. I am a lovable person. There's no hate ever in my heart, ever when you see me. There's no hate. And I have no ill feelings towards anybody that I've ever worked with. Honestly, you know, I tell it like it is. It is what it is. And over time, you get over it. I just want people to know that I'm a good person, and I always, on this platform, fought for women, and I don't feel like people fought for me, but I definitely fought for the women I thought that should be in position. Yes, Claudia, I fought for you, girl.
You did.
You got that peach, honey. Yes. Now you can keep talking about me as all you want to, okay? I fought for a lot of people. Yes, Portia, I fought for you. You're on here. Cynthia Hilaire, thank you. So I did. I don't feel like it was all returned, but that's okay, because you don't do things for things to be returned. They will all come back in due time. Now, this is the moment where, yes, microphone, I'm here for, this is the moment where... This is the moment where I have to turn on you.
Okay, go ahead. I'm ready.
Yes, honey, cross your legs and do not edit it out.
No, we're going to keep this. Let's go.
Okay, so, I mean, you worked behind the scenes when I was on the show for so many seasons. Do you feel that I was always giving fair treatment?
Well, this is the thing. I feel like because the show was new, mm-hmm. and all of us were very new to this, I felt like we were all underestimated. 1,000%. 1,000%. Mm-hmm. I know that my passion and me being so maniacal in terms of making the show great was because we were Black people. And I know mm-hmm. that as Black people, we're always underestimated and we don't mm-hmm. get our just due. It's just the way the cookie crumbles.
Right.
And I know that when it came to this show, you girls worked your asses off.
Yeah.
And deserved to be number one.
Yeah.
And I felt like when it came to you, look, I think what happens is there's no instruction manual of what it's like to handle fame.
Yeah.
And to be known within the local city mm-hmm. and then to be an international success. And I think people just did not know what to do with you. Mm-hmm. They just didn't know. It was like, wait, what? What's going on here? Like, wait, what? And I do feel like you may be the most underrepresented reality star in the world. You are. Mm-hmm. I think you deserve a walk on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Mm-hmm. I think you should have talk shows and podcast deals, and you should be on Netflix scripted shows. I see some reality stars who have opportunities that I think like, oh, NeNe should have had that years ago. I know that you have paved the way for Black reality stars, the females. I know that there's females that you and I are talking about in reality TV, who shall remain nameless, who have looked you dead in the eye and said, what do? Like, they look up to you. You paved the way. Mm-hmm. Tammy Roman says that. Tiffany Pollard even says that. You literally are the queen. And I do feel like when it comes to where things are now, it does sadden me. I just don't understand why you aren't on network television, reading the Girls for Filth, having a good time. And I do agree with you. I think if not bigger, you should be on the same level as Kim Kardashian.
Yeah. Excuse me while I get the tear out the side of my eye.
Don't cry, bitch. But no, I think, listen, I'm happy we're doing this because, listen, we all make mistakes. And I think we all can look back on our time and say, I should have done that differently. I could have handled that better. My hope for you and the people involved in this situation, from Andy to Bravo to the companies, I just want you guys to have a conversation. I think if people were in a room without the lawyers and people in your ear, I know for a fact that a 3-hour lunch can eradicate all of this. And it saddens me deeply that I have to sit back and watch a woman who paved the way even for me to be able to sit in this room across from you. And it makes me sad because it's not okay. And I do feel like, look, I feel like when it comes to you, you've done so much for this industry. And I feel like you've done so much for this genre. And I feel like you've done so much for everybody. And I hate that people can't make mistakes, say dumb shit,
right,
and not say, okay, bitch, let's figure it out. You and I have falling out. Like, me and you went toe-to-toe.
Yeah.
And we got back together because it wasn't that deep. And what you're going through, to me, just isn't that fucking deep. Get the fuck over it. Sit down. Have the conversation. It's stupid as fuck. I think it's dumb. I really do believe if everybody was in the room for 3 hours and just talked it out, yell at each other, bitch, you did that, and in the end say, okay, well, we got it out. Let's move on. Mm-hmm. It pains me. It pains me because it doesn't have to be this way. Mm-hmm. And I feel like ego gets in the way. But with you, I really want you to know that you deserve so much more than what this world is giving you. And I feel horrible that you are going through what you're going through. This bitch got me crying on TV. Anyways, continue.
Oh my God. So I know you've been watching Real Housewives the new seasons.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God, I'm sorry. Oh my goodness. I know you're watching the new seasons of Housewives. So what do you think that Real Housewives of Atlanta needs?
A clean slate. I think, look, and I just got to be honest. I think the reason why
people... So Sweet 16 is coming.
What's that?
Season 16.
Oh, Sweet 16. Oh, that's so funny. No, listen, I think no one is showing up to work.
That's true.
No one's showing up to work. I remember coming to your boutique and you were, I think this was season 10 or 11, and you said, bitch, they don't know what to do without you. She said, these girls walk around like, what do we do? Don't. Carlos ain't here, bitch. Mm-hmm. What are we doing?
Because you put a battery in their bag.
Ah!
You do. You have told Kenya everything to say. You're like, now go.
Oh, no.
You put
no.
a battery in their bag.
And you always thought Kenya was my favorite.
Yes. You. Now, who's your favorite, though?
By the I love way? All of y'all equally.
No, that's a lie. Who's your favorite, honey? Kenya's always been your favorite.
You said Sheree
and
was
you
at one point.
Around and like Sheree, too.
I love, I'll be honest. Mm-hmm. I have a very, listen, you and I have this chemistry mm-hmm. that's undeniable, and we mm-hmm. have this love, and people just, it's infectious.
Yeah, but besides that, honey.
No, listen.
Keep it 1,000. You love talking to Sheree.
I love, you know, I do
and
love
and you
Sheree.
Would sneak around and love Marlo on the side, too.
I do love, no, yeah, that's the I thing. Was, I do, I love the girls.
You do. You would sneak around.
I love the girls.
You know what? I feel like you're like Janet Jackson. She would say that her relationships with her siblings would change. Like, okay, Michael would be her favorite for a little while.
And ooh, then she'll switch
into
LaToya
being her favorite. And then she said that's how it
good.
Would be because she's in a big family. So I feel like you would switch, like, right now, Nene's my favorite. And then later on, you'll be like, you know what? Sheree's my favorite.
Okay.
Kenya's my favorite.
I'll receive that. That's
you
the
switch.
Answer.
You switch.
I would switch. Yeah. It would depend on the season. It would depend on the season. There you go.
Okay. Besides me, who on Housewives or who's been on Housewives that you feel is a star? Okay, there aren't any.
No, I do. No, no, no. Listen, if I had to choose one, I think Kenya is a star.
Okay.
I will
give you that because, as I said, I feel like there was a moment when I feel like Kenya was a star, and then I feel like reality TV made people be like, I don't know if I like her.
Yeah, yeah. So I would say Kenya.
And she's your favorite. So I knew you would say that.
Whatever. I don't have any
so
favorites this season.
For the men, because that's another thing I would say. And would you agree that when we were on, the men played a very big
oh, 100%.
Part of the show. And I don't feel like we hear about the men anymore as much. And the men, we did a couples trip. You remember? We used to do a couples trip and stuff like that. And so who's your favorite couple? Who has your favorite couple been?
Oh, and listen, I will go on the record. Nene and Greg. No one will ever top Nene and Greg. I would call him dad.
Mm-hmm. Do you think the men should be more involved?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. The problem is... these women don't want to pay the men 15% of their check anymore.
I never gave my husband 15%
no, that was
of
different.
My check.
No, that's the thing Peter and Cynthia talked about.
Yeah.
I just, listen, there's a certain level of producing and understanding that show needs. It's the DNA. I do say, like Destiny's Child, there's a certain level of camaraderie and people that you need. And I feel like everyone's bored. I feel like no one knows what they're doing. I feel like people are there for the wrong reasons. And it's always about the intention. And the intention of everyone involved is not at its highest at all.
Okay.
No.
So if you had to pick a cast for season Sweet 16, who would it be?
Okay, and you have the answer too.
Oh, why?
Because you do. And this is my real answer. Nene, Kim, Sheree, Kenya, Portia, Phaedra, and Candy.
I don't see Phaedra being it.
That's my dream. I feel like we were robbed of getting a Candy and Phaedra conversation.
I do too. Now, I've always said that.
I felt
that was very
and I'm gonna
unfair
say it,
to the viewers.
And I'm going to say
too.
It. I'm going to stand on this hill.
Me too.
Now the pump rules. Mm-hmm. Those white kids mm-hmm. said we're dealing with something devastating and crazy, mm-hmm. and we're all going to show up and work. Mm-hmm. And we all get to show our story, and now this show was nominated for an Emmy, I feel like, listen, I'm not here to judge what people did. It doesn't involve me. It's whatever.
Right.
God is the only person who judges us. Mm-hmm. As a producer, I feel mm-hmm. like at the end of the day, to your point, if she can forgive Portia, yeah. why can't, and we got a chance to see that.
That's right.
We should have saw that with Phaedra. And because we did not see Phaedra and Candy deal with the aftermath, mm-hmm. it ruined the show.
And it's been years. They could have, she didn't have to be a regular on the show. They should have sat down.
Yeah.
Everybody wants to know
why. It would have been the highest rated season, and it may have been Emmy nominated.
Well, they control those nominations. So I don't know about all of that. Do you think it's time to have a gay couple on the Real Housewives franchise?
Yeah, listen, I'm all about making sure the shows represent where we are in the world, and mm-hmm. I like the fact that we get to showcase different couples, for sure, yeah. Hmm. Who okay. is your, if you were able to cast the Sweet 16, who would be on your list?
First of all, I don't even know the girls that are on the show over there. I would not say myself. I would say Portia, for sure. I think Portia's quite entertaining. I think you have to have Candy because she's been there for so long and people feel like, you know, for whatever reason, Candy needs to be there, and that way Candy can get ripped and she needs to be there. Marlo is good there. I think Kenya will be there. I have had a few run-ins with Drew. Just he used to patronize my lounge a lot. So I have a, you know, I think she's good there. I think I like seeing Drew on the show. I don't have anyone else that I would say at the moment. I can't say Phaedra, and I can't say Sheree.
Okay.
I don't mind Kim if she's coming to go to work.
Yes, agreed.
Yeah, because a lot of times she doesn't come to work. So that will be an issue there.
Okay.
I also think they need to find somebody new. There's so many fabulous girls in Atlanta, Georgia, who has personalities and they have great husbands. And I think they need some new blood on the show mm-hmm. as well. I think all of the friends that are currently on the show, I don't know what they're doing. Just the thought of Manetta. And I think there's a girl who's a housewife. What's her name? She runs track.
Sonya.
Sonya. I didn't know. I've met her before. She seems very nice. I just don't feel like she's a housewife. She don't give me that housewife feeling. I think her and they can say goodbye.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't think they are it for the show.
Well, that's that.
Let me see, because I had something else for you, honey.
Go ahead.
Oh, I think you said it earlier. I don't know that if the camera was rolling, would you have a baby?
I do. I want a boy and a girl, and I got their names picked out.
Their name is Cash and Money.
Ah!
Because, you know, these girls will get mad about Cash.
Okay,
you know,
they will get Cash with a K, bitch.
Yes, yes.
No, I would love to have, listen, I would love to leave everything I built to some of my kids. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I would love to see a little sassy girl read these girls for filth and say, my dad is Carlos King, bitch. And
I know you would tell her, honey.
Yes.
Uh-huh. She'd be walking around here snapping and popping, honey.
Exactly. Wearing Lululemon.
Lululemon. From working out, honey.
Yes,
I live, honey.
Because you go to work, the girls in work.
Well, I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
I think you should be doing in-person interviews.
Okay, I
will. I don't think that you should do them on Zoom. You know, I just don't think it looks cute with your sneakers in the background. I think you should have some nice background like this, and the guests should always be sitting with you. Make enough money where you can fly them in and coach, rather.
Ah!
And they can upgrade their own ticket. And I think you should do in person. I think it's just so much more fun. And I think you'll get so much more out of it.
Okay.
And I feel like the viewers will really enjoy it. I also agree with everything that you said about me, because it's all true. sure, I should be doing so much
yes,
more.
Yes, and you will. And you
and,
will.
I'm okay with it, though. I think God has a plan for me.
He does.
And it's
He
okay.
never misses.
Yeah, so I'm good. I'm very good right now.
Feed into yeah. Him.
Yes.
And He
yes,
will sir. Give you... Psalm 37:4, delight mm-hmm. in the Lord, and mm-hmm. He will give you the desires mm-hmm. of your heart.
I think I'm going to be just fine.
You know, I know you are going to be. Would mm-hmm. you do Love and Marriage Atlanta?
I'm not in a marriage. And I don't even have a current love. I guess my eyes are loving on some people, but I'm not currently in love with anybody.
Okay.
I'm not in a relationship. But if they want a single girl on the show to flirt with their husbands, sure. Because every show has a single person, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so I don't mind being the single. This will be the first time in my life I've ever done anything where I'm like the single person.
Okay.
So you never know. By the time Love and Marriage Atlanta hits Atlanta, maybe I'll be available. Or maybe I'll be in a relationship.
Okay.
You never know. So are you planning to do that?
Only if I'm able to get you.
Well, you can only have stars around me. I don't want those tired girls that you go and drag up from some other old show and you're sending them over here. I do not want that. So, you know, think about that. I have some great ideas. You have to have good girls.
No, and I have a great idea. You and I should go on tour together.
I love to go on tour. What are we going to be talking about?
Anything. I want to do a tour with you.
Well, let's go.
Where we're going city to city weekend. And just talk.
Oh, people would love to come.
Yes.
People would love to come. The girls and the gays, honey, out for a conversation.
There we go.
And the people will be sitting. Look at Red. He'll be standing
okay,
right
Red
there.
Okay, Red and his thighs.
Yes. Come on, big thighs.
Uh-huh. Big thighs, big. Okay.
Look at Red. Red said, this is not it. He said, I can't. Red said, I can't. I don't want to imagine you talking about my damn thighs. But let me tell you. This has been really great.
I've enjoyed it.
I'm happy that I came at a time when I was ready. Well, first, let me go back for a second before I say that. I noticed that you had the Real Housewives, the OGs, and I wasn't a part of that. Was that the time that you called me?
Yes.
And I said I wasn't ready?
Yes, it was.
Oh, but you didn't tell me that it was going
to
be
you never know. So just to go back to that, each girl did not know it was going to be a reunion.
Oh, okay.
Everybody was surprised.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, that's why I said no. Had I known it was going to be a whole group, I would have said, oh, maybe I'll come.
Okay. Well, listen.
But I'm glad those girls went on. I'm glad to have the seat by myself. I don't want to share the air.
Well, I think when you and I go on tour, we will invite When you and I go on tour, we'll invite Kim, Sheree, Lisa, and Deshaun to sit on the stage with us.
I'm actually in a really good place right now.
I can tell.
I think this is the place. I don't know if you're looking, sir, but you know, this is the place.
Well, Nene,
this is the place to be in.
Can't thank you enough. I love you. You're my sis forever.
You're mine too. I love you forever. Come on, knees.
Yes!
I'm so glad you have grown in so many ways, Carlo. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
I feel like I'm your mom in many ways.
Yes.
And I'm very proud of
you. Thank
you. Honestly, I'm happy you're able to do this and do this on your own term. I don't even know. Why did you think to do a podcast? You just thought, I'm just going to start talking or what?
I've been asked to do one for years, and I felt like the time was right.
Mm-hmm.
And I have so much wisdom to offer to the community that because I'm confident, I don't really give a fuck what y'all think about me in this world. Mm-hmm. The time was now.
And the time is now, so you just came out, and you and Kanye West are doing well.
So thank you so much for watching Reality with the King. Catch us on YouTube, on audio every Tuesday, and we will see you soon.
Okay. Oh, hold on one second. We have to back up because we need to talk about what I'm doing currently.
Yeah, so what are you up to, Nene?
So I'm up to a lot of things. Actually, you know, I'm back working, which I thank God for because these people were trying to keep me from working forever. But one of the things I'm really passionate about is I have an organization called Ladies of Success.
Yes.
It's for entrepreneur women around the world, like-minded women to form friendships, learn how to increase their bottom lines. If you are a woman anywhere in the world that's interested in being a part of Ladies of Success, please go to our website, which is ladiesofsuccess.com, and we'd love to have you.
Amen. Thank you, Nene Leakes, the queen of reality TV, the greatest housewife of all time. Thank you, sis.
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you. I love you all. Thank you. Follow me on social media for the latest and greatest information. Carlos, honey, why are you this small, honey? Have you been eating?